Hi, let's look into the Incoterms. Incoterms is an abbreviation of International Commercial Terms, which tells about the rules for the responsibilities of exporter and importer at the time of exporting and importing the goods under different contracts. It tells about the responsibilities. It tells about the rules. It tells about the how you can share the expenses. So all these things are coming under the Incoterms. So let's look into the Incoterms importance. It clearly defines and sets international rules for foreign trade. It tells about the obligations of both parties involved in the transactions. Clearly tells the obligations of exporter and importer at the time of foreign trade. It also determines the distribution and transfer of risk from seller to the buyer. It clearly states how the exporter and importer sharing the expenses at the time of transportation. So there are different terms: FOB, FAS, FOT, FOR, free delivered CIF, CNF. Likewise, there are different Incoterms. Let's look into one by one. The first one is EXW, which means Ex Works. Ex Works means that seller's responsibility is to make the goods available at the seller's premises. It's not the responsibility of a seller to deliver it to the buyer's premises. His responsibility is to make the goods at seller's premises. Seller is not responsible for loading the goods on the vehicle provided by the buyer. Buyer will give you the vehicle. If you are a seller, they will give you the vehicle. But seller is not responsible for loading these goods on the vehicle provided by the buyer. That's Ex Works. Ex Works means seller's responsibility is to make the goods available at seller's premises only. Then the second one is Free Carrier, FCA. FCA means that seller fulfill its obligation to deliver when it has handed over the goods cleared for export into the charge of the carrier named by the buyer at the named place. Which means that seller must hand over the goods to the carrier given by the buyer at the named place. That's known as FCA. So exporter has the obligation to deliver the goods into the custody of the carrier named by the buyer. Or seller can choose it. Seller can choose the carrier, and seller will definitely deliver the goods to that carrier. It is his responsibility. It is known as FCA. Then the next one is CIP. That is carriage and insurance paid to. What's the meaning of that? CIP is known as seller pays for the insurance against the loss of damage. Seller will make the payment of the insurance. Seller will make the payment of carriage expense. So seller will bear two costs, carriage expense as well as insurance. Then the seller or exporter arranging for the export clearance for all export formalities. An exporter will arrange and pay for all costs for the transportation, including insurance of the goods up to the agreed point into the port of destination. That's actually known as CIP, insurance and carriage expense bared by the seller. That's the peculiarity of CIP. Then the next one is delivered at terminal, DAT. Seller bears the cost of transport and the risk also until the goods are left unloaded at the terminal that the both of the parties are agreed. So what is the peculiarity of this? Seller or exporter will take the cost of transportation as well as the risk. Okay, that's known as DAT. So you know that what is terminal? It can be a warehouse, or it can be a container yard, or it can be a road, rail, or cargo terminal, whatever it is. Okay, So seller will bear all the cost of transportation and also bear the risk until the goods are left unloaded at the terminal. So up to that time, seller will bear the cost. That is known as DAP. Then the next one is delivered at place. It means that seller will deliver when the goods are placed at the disposal of the buyer on the arriving means of transport ready for unloading at the named place of destination. That means seller know that there will be a named place for delivering the goods. So seller will bear all the risk for bringing the goods into that named place. Okay, named place of destination. It's not to the carrier. And buyer will tell this is the place which you want to load the goods. Up to that time period, seller will bear the risk as well as the cost. That's known as delivered at place. Then next is delivered duty paid. Seller has to bear the cost involved in shipping the goods as well as the cost and risk of carrying out the customs formalities. All customs formalities, duty paid, duty, all expenses has to bear by the seller. That's known as DDP. Example, if the buyer some additional cost will incur due to the clearance of the goods for the import exactly at the right time, and who will bear that cost? Buyer has to pay any additional cost, but seller will pay the duty. Okay. Seller will definitely pay the duty, but buyer has to pay any additional cost due to the failure to clear the goods for the import at the correct time. That's actually known as DDP. Then the next one is FOB, free on board. It's known as the goods are placed on the board of the ship by the seller at a port of shipment named in the sales agreement. So there will be a port name will be mentioned in the agreement. In that port name, there is a ship. So on that ship, the goods are placed by the seller. The risk of loss or damage to the goods is transferred to the buyer when the goods pass the ship's rail. Once the goods are handed over to the ship's rail, then the risk and loss of damage will be transferred to the buyer, then the buyer's responsibility. From that time onwards, it is the responsibility of the buyer to bear the risk and loss. But the seller will pay the cost of loading the goods. The next is cost and freight. It requires the seller will pay the cost and freight necessary to bring the goods to the named destination. Seller will bear the cost and freight expenses for bringing it to the place. But the risk of loss or damage to the goods as well as any cost increases are transferred from seller to the buyer when the goods pass the ship's rail. It's like the previous one. The only difference is cost and freight has to be bear by the seller. Then the next one is cost insurance and freight. CIF means that cost insurance and freight followed by a named port of destination. Seller must in addition to procure and pay for the buyer's insurance. It's not only the cost charges, freight charges and insurance charges also must be paid by the seller. So this is applicable only in the case of maritime transport. The next is free alongside ship, FAS. FAS means that seller is responsible for the cost of transporting and delivering goods alongside a vessel in a port in his country. It means that buyer has to bear all the cost and risk or loss of damage to the goods from that moment. Okay, so from that moment, buyer has to bear the cost. But seller's responsibility is to bear the cost of transportation and delivery only. Then from that time onwards, whatever risk bears, whatever cost incurred, all this must be bared by the buyer. This term is applicable only for sea and inland waterway transport. That's known as FAS. Thank you.